Hey, welcome to another video of the Millennial Guru. After the widespread of the pandemic, people went into quarantine and people locked themselves in their house and everyone started working from home. People started working from home, they started attending meetings on video calls, people started doing business on video calls, and at the same time a lot of students also started studying in online classes. We're going to learn etiquettes for online video calls. Test your camera and microphone ahead of time. A lot of people start fumbling and they start trying to connect their cameras and they start trying to connect their microphone once everybody's already in the meeting, when everyone's already waiting. It creates a lot of awkwardness and wastes people's time. Before you join any video conference, you should make sure that your devices are working, your laptop battery is charged, so that you don't have to get up in the middle of the meeting and walk out and get it charged. It's very important to check your devices beforehand. Choose a location with good lighting. Lighting plays a very important role in your video calls. So before you even start a video call, you should check your cameras and see where you get the best light. You could sit in front of a window, you could sit outside, you could sit somewhere where, you know, nobody's going to disturb you, but at the same time the lightings are good and they are falling on your face and not behind you. It's very creepy when you're talking to somebody and that person's face is hidden, that person's face is dark. It feels like you're talking to some kidnapper or a gangster. So you should take care of your lighting. Do introduce yourself before you start talking. Not everybody knows you or not everybody recognizes your voice. So unless everybody you know already know and you have worked with in the call, it is important to introduce your name, maybe even your last name, when you start talking. Give your brief introduction before you start so people know whom they are listening to. Do dress appropriately. It is very important to dress formally when you are sitting in front of a video call. It's fine if you are wearing your underwear or your shorts or whatever you're wearing below the waist level, but above the waist level you should be wearing something formal and presentable. So every morning when you sit in front of your laptop or camera, make sure that you're wearing something presentable, because you don't know when a call will come. So instead of running at the moment you get a video call and looking for your t-shirt and shirt, it is a good idea to wear a good shirt and sit in front of your camera. A very important point: learn to mute yourself and your background noises when you're not speaking. A lot of people have no idea that their microphone is on and you can listen to the kitchen cooker's whistle play going on, small babies crying in the background. You can even hear birds chirping, people's phones ringing, and a lot of other awkward sounds. It's a definitely good idea to mute yourself and mute the background noises that are in your surrounding when you're not speaking. It's also important to inform the people in your house, in your family, that you are on a video call and you expect them to be silent. And here are some don'ts that you should not do, things that you should not do during a video call. It is a cardinal sin to call somebody without informing them that you're calling them on their phone, because everybody is unprepared, nobody is prepared to attend video calls. It's definitely a good idea to use body language, but during video calls, don't rely too much on your body language. You don't know how slow your system is or how slow the internet is, and if you rely too much on your hand gestures, people might not get the idea of what you're saying. It's important to articulate everything that you're saying. If you're pointing at a PPT slide or you're showing something in the background, it is important to describe what you're pointing at. If you just point your finger to something and talk about it, people might not get the idea what you're speaking about. So don't rely too much on your body language. Don't interrupt somebody when they're talking on a video call. It is bad. It's considered a taboo to speak when somebody is already talking, because it distracts everybody. It distracts everybody from the point that is going on. So wait for people to complete their turn before you start talking. Always be an active listener even when you're talking. It's important to be an active listener when you're talking, even when you're talking. There are times when somebody's trying to interrupt you or tell you something, but then you go on non-stop without stopping. It is important to notice when somebody says a word or it is important to notice people's body language, and if somebody has a question, a confused look, you can definitely address them and talk to them and then sort get it out of the way and then continue with your talk. Don't multitask in the background. It's definitely not a good idea to check your emails or look at a website during your video calls. People can easily look at the camera and they can figure out from your facial expressions whether you're reading text, you're reading a message, you're going through a video or looking at or attending the conference. So it is important to not do that. Don't be that guy, don't be that annoying guy who is doing his personal activity during a video call. It is alright to eat while you're having a video call, but then at least when you're talking or when it is your turn to speak, make sure that you're not having any food in the background and you're not eating or slurping your food or chewing it while you're talking. That's the most annoying thing you can do. Often, a lot of people avoid turning on their cameras, which is also bad. It is very difficult to engage with people when their cameras are turned off. So keep your cameras on so people can see your face and they can see that you are listening to them. It helps them to connect better when they can see you. So even when it is not your turn, it is a good sign to keep your camera open. I hope you follow these tips on your next video call, and I hope they might be helpful to you. Thank you for watching this video. Please share, subscribe, and like if you enjoyed watching this video.